Hello, welcome to 50 Questions Friday for July 29th at 22. Gosh, if you are here live, please do drop your questions in the questions tab. And otherwise, if you'd like to attend live, please join us by simply going to Twistedsage.com, registering for our newsletter, and we will send you a link weekly when we do the 50 questions. So, all right. Well, good morning, everybody. Thank you all for being here today. First question from John. Brian, good morning. I'm confused. Has the new energy been placed in all the tools or in just the new ones? Gotcha. So, you know, with the new energy, the new energetics that we put into the new tools here at the beginning of this month, or in the middle of this month here, I guess, it went into the ones that we call the new energy, because those ones had not been completely fully anchored in yet, the new energy tools. And so that was fully anchored in. And then it also came into all of the wisdom tools. Sorry, I have a retainer. I got to get out of my mouth because, pardon me. And now my tongue can move, right? So the new energy is in the wisdom tools. The new energy is also in the alchemist trios. Now, the alchemist sets, when you have all three of the alchemist rings together, which is the divine I am, the chalice, and the harmonizer, they then hold that wisdom field, that field of the new energy. Now, you might not necessarily find that new energy in just a harmonizer ring, but you will in the trio. So again, the new energy is in the tools labeled new energy. It's in the tools that are the wisdom tools and the alchemist trios. Now, the truth of it is that once we begin to put in these energies into the etheric templates, they begin to shift all of the tools. Now, so truly all the tools that we create have taken a step up, and they will continue to step up, but they're still going to be basically the harmony rings are still the harmony ring. But the golden fire, when the golden fire came in, the golden fire started to seep its way into that harmony field as well. So that original balance and harmony ring does have a little bit of the energetics of the golden fire. But what I noted the other day was that harmony is also that chalice energy has seeped into every one of the tools that we create, that chalice energy, which is that crystal clear, pure consciousness light. That is in all the tools right now as well. Now, I know this whole thing is confusing. So basically, let's just put it this way, that there is still all of these different frequencies of tools. We have the harmony, the original balance and harmony. We have golden fire, regeneration. We have the chalice. We have, you know, the harmonizer, the divine I am, the wisdom, the new energy, all of these spectrums of the tools are all still their own energetic signature. You can still tell the difference between a harmony ring and a harmonizer ring. You know, you can still tell that difference by just looking, feeling at them. So, I mean, there's still a difference in the energetics, but the thing is that all the energetics are starting to smooth out a little bit to where a lot of this newer stuff is permeating into all of the tools, which is a great thing. You know, I would love to see it that we sell only one single thing, a single tensor ring, you know, well, you know, a tensor ring and a tensor field generator and a Gaia sphere and a tensor coil and all sizes of rings, you know, but just one energetic is how I would love to see this. But we're not there yet, because right now we still need to offer all of the different energetic spectrum for those who are looking and want to resonate with that energetic spectrum. But what my intention behind this whole thing is that we do have this energetic spectrum here of the different tools. my intention is that overall, they are all going to start carrying this highest potentials of the energies, so that if you have a harmony ring and you have that bandwidth energetics that you resonate with this harmony, but yet this harmony is able to, you are able to access all the energies through this harmony. That is my intention, is that we're going to get to there and to get to there very soon, so that it doesn't really matter what tool you would buy at that time, that it will take you to the highest potentialities. That's the intention here, because that way there is that opening for whatever a person resonates with. But as they come in, they're not limited to just that potential. They're not limited at all. They're open to all of the higher potentials. I almost feel that is beginning to happen already, because like I say, even the original balance and harmony rings have shifted immensely over the years. You know, the only tools that really never shifted, you know, would be like the original 144 and 177 and 188, which we don't even make anymore. I'm sure we could still shift those energetics too. But we just don't work with them. We really want to simplify, John. So our intention with the creation of the tools is truly to simplify. We still all need something that resonates with us that we can step into. And just saying good morning to everybody that's here today. And I always thank you all for joining today and hanging out here. And we have people from all over the world. Gosh, I'd love to come and visit all of you guys in all of your locations. So we do have a polls option on here too. I was thinking about doing some polling, question asking of you guys, because, you know, there's still quite a few people that, you know, we get like 90 people a week that register, third to a half of you guys show up live, and I know hundreds of people watch it on YouTube after the fact, within the first week. So I'd like to keep offering this, for my, the 50 questions Friday for myself. This is really my only outlet into the world right now, as I've been on sabbatical for like 5 years or whatever it is. But now that I'm going to start teaching again and everything else, just wasn't sure whether you guys still want to do a weekly get together or not a weekly get together. Renard, you said I am muted there. Okay. Yeah. Still going. So anyway, we might do a poll. I don't know if you guys can access the polls tab on here or not. I think I might have to be the one that adds the poll. There were some other thoughts too, was that we can do things here on this platform that we can start opening it up for, you know, instead of typing in questions, that we can actually open it up so that you guys can just personally ask the questions. So that's an option too, for us to think about, so I'm not sure where we want to go with 50 questions Friday, because I know, a lot of you are here every week and I really appreciate that you are. But I just want to make sure that we are, bringing what we need and using our time, correctly. So anyway, I'm not sure where to go from here, because we don't have a lot of tool questions that are coming in, in the past don't know, in the past few months that we've been doing 50 Questions Friday, not a lot of emails on tool questions. And I know a lot of people that pop in here are like first timers, and then we might do a meditation, or else I'll go off on a tangent about consciousness work. And then they're like, oh shit, what did I get myself into here? You know, so I'm not sure whether, you know, we should maybe focus on only tools and do something separate for consciousness work. I don't want to do a builder thing, a builder platform. I just not really drawn to do teaching on creation of tools, but happy to do, you know, things with consciousness. That's my passion, is the consciousness work. But you know, we still need to be able to answer the questions on tools. And so anyway, just kind of throwing some things out there, you guys, maybe over here on the chat side, or on the question side, just would like some feedback, on what you guys that attend here every week, what it is that you would like to see more of. You know, is it more in the tools, more on the consciousness work, meditations? You know, I'm just really don't know where to go. So anyway, if we have some questions, we'll jump back here again. Laura, how can I clean the wings of Tok? I use vinegar and salt, but the middle part remained the same. So, gosh, electroplating on the wings of Tok. Now, the wings of Tok and the key pendants, they're all steel. They're a steel core. That's what the straight tines are, because copper, or, you know, it has to be that way to hold the energetics. So with those steel tines, we electroplate the tool. Now, that copper electroplating, it's a very thin plating, so we don't suggest using steel wool on it, because as any electroplated jewelry goes, you don't want to, you know, use steel wool, because you can rub that plating off. You know, if you scrub too hard, we still use a very fine steel wool, and you can lightly touch it up just to bring a little bit of the shine back. But if you scrub it too much or too often, you'll remove the plating. Now, here's what we offer on the electroplated tools, is that after, especially like the pendants, after you wear them for a while, in any electroplating jewelry, that plating will come off. Eventually it wears off. So if your plating wears off, you know, that is something that we offer to electroplate those for free. So you just send it back in, we run it through the polisher, and then we electroplate it. You know, and I only electroplate maybe once every 3 to 4 weeks. So, you know, you might be without the tool for a couple of weeks, but you're still welcome to send it in anytime. Now, as far as your self-cleaning of the Wings of Tok pendant, or the Wings of Tok, or the key pendant, all the electroplated tools, that vinegar and salt solution, just to take off some of the patina, but you might not ever be able to get it to that original shine. Because like the salt, vinegar, and acid solution with copper will take off that darker color on it, but it doesn't do the polish. It doesn't bring it to the shine. That actually takes like a mechanical polishing. So that's why I say that fine grade steel wool is a little bit rough. I wish I had a better solution and a better answer for you, but I would say just try to polish it up with that fine, fine grade steel wool, which is a triple four or a quadruple four. It is a 4 zeros. It's a quadruple zero. So it's a 0000 is the grade of the steel wool, the finest you can get. That is what you can use after you've taken the patina off, to just do a fine polish. And then if you remove the plating, send it in to us and we'll replate it for you. Sorry for the long answer there, Laura, but I hope that helps. Renard, the new energy coil gave me another vibration heart pulse. Just want to say thanks for those. I really enjoy them. Interesting. I know I've been loving my new energy coil too. It's been something. It holds a pretty phenomenal field. And of course that is in, that is also in that new tensor coil, which used to be the golden fire coil. So the golden fire coil pendant, which was a smaller coil, and it has the infinity on the bottom. That has been one of our mainstays for years since the harmony. Maybe before that, actually. And I started with the galactic. But anyway, that particular coil is no longer the golden fire coil. It is now listed simply as a tensor coil. That too is in the new energy, as is the silver. So the silver, it looks like a little golden fire coil. It's 4 inches long with the infinity. So it's a silver coil and the silver infinity. That one too is in the new energy. And so if you're still unsure of what the new energies are, actually on the website, there's one of the categories of new energy. And within that category, that will show you all of the tools that we have that are in the new energy. And Susanna, I just got the new energy coil yesterday, and I agree, the heart feels different. I used it when I went to sleep and had a restful night. So, gosh, you know, there is so much that is shifting and changing with the human, with your light body, with your electromagnetic body, just everything that is coming in with that quantum mind, all of that. And yeah, these coil pendants are pretty powerful in just harmonizing and aligning all the aspects of you as the human. I don't mean soul aspects. I mean like the energy bodies, everything. It just aligns. Nika, I felt there was a big shift a couple days ago. Was there an update to the tools? And do you have any insights to some of the changes going on? So, gosh, there's been so many shifts taking place. Oh gosh, I was trying to remember, there was a big shift here recently. I think that was the one that was a couple weeks ago that we put into the tools. You know, I don't remember anything. You know, I need to keep writing blogs every time something cool happens, because or else it's gone, which is perfect because it's all turned into wisdom. It's here somewhere. It's just not in this mental processing thing that takes up all the space. But whatever, you know. So, yeah, don't remember anything. But I know that there's a lot of shifts that are taking place. We, you know, we just did a big thing yesterday up at the medicine wheel, the Bighorn medicine wheel. Yesterday, my sister Brenda and my mom and Mary from the shop here all went up there. We got up at the wheel at 4 o'clock in the morning before any sunrise was coming up. Then we hung out and we did ceremony during one of the twilights, and after the sunrise, we came home. But it was pretty powerful there too. I'm going to redo the audio because I did some recordings of that, and I'll see about putting that out, because it's just in the video, it allows you to jump into that space, which is pretty phenomenal. It's just more clearing, deeper clearing. Oh yes, actually something huge did happen. Gosh, last week too with the tools. So yeah, there's been some shifts with the tools. And every time that we go through a shift, that goes into the tools as well. And, you know, I think things are growing even more exponentially right now than that. So, and jump back over here to chat. Ah, Fernando uses a silver cleaning cloth to clean the wings of Tok so that the electroplating lasts longer. That's phenomenal advice. The silver cleaning cloth. Because that does do a polish as well as help to remove some of the patina. So yeah, the silver cleaning cloths might be a way to do it. And if you just wipe it every day too, that's a great way because it's actually our oils that help to patina it a lot, depending upon your chemistry. Let's see. And here I was asking some more feedback. Let's see. I'm interested in the creative and successful examples of how people have used the tools. And that really is a great idea. Let's see, Faith. I would enjoy hearing more about consciousness work, but I also like hearing about the tools and their service. Let's see. And just here's a comment that Stephanie mentioned. I feel more attuned to crystals as the wisdom wand, and I are integrated fully with the new energy. You know, it is amazing how... you know, working in those wisdom fields, not only the crystals, but just everything in creation. It's like consciousness. So it's like, you know, us as the human can pick up a crystal and be like, oh yeah, and that feels good and feel this and feel that. But, you know, really with the wisdom tools, that is bringing in that higher consciousness. And so we're able to work more with the consciousness of this particular crystal or the consciousness of that plant, the morphogenic field of that entire species. You know, it just opens us up to working with things like crystals and anything else that has consciousness in a whole different way. So yeah, working with these wisdom tools is really phenomenal for stepping into more. Let's see. And just reading some more comments here about the question that I posed about what we should do with 50 Questions Friday. Meditations, the consciousness work and insights. And then here's a suggestion to every other week for 50 Questions Friday. Love hearing about the energy updates. Yeah, you know, that's kind of what I've been thinking too, is to moving 50 Questions Friday to every other week. But, you know, I'm terrible at set schedules, so I might just say, okay, we'll do 2 a month instead of 4 a month. And we'll see if they go every other week. Let's see. Let's see. Magic erasers for cleaning copper. And you can use them wet or dry. That might actually work too. And this was just a thought that Marguerite had, was the magic erasers, which, you know, they are pretty magical as magic erasers are. It's quite possibly. Okay, well, thank you all for some of the feedback here on, you know, on 50 Questions Friday. And I'll certainly sit with it all here too, just to see. But, you know, as everything's going, you know, reinventing and changing all the time. Let's see, Fernando, does the energy move in a similar toroidal field for both the new silver coil and the new spinning torus pendant that spins? Okay, so the question about the way the toroidal field moves in a torus versus how it moves in a coil. Yes, they are basically the same field, that they are the one that spins. So it's like the North Pole to the South Pole that goes this way, but the energy also flows this way. So it's flowing both ways. Within that energy spins too. So it spins, but then it also spins this way. So this torus is just this flowing energy field. Then if you looked at this torus, you know, here's the torus. If you looked at it from the top, it would almost represent, it would almost resemble this infinity that just keeps flowing and flowing and always intersects in the center. You know, and then there's kind of a, there's a little video GIF image on, I believe it's on the Taurus page, that shows some of the toroidal field, just to give you a visual. You know, there's not too many images out there that show a true Taurus and how it moves and flows. But both the Alchemist Taurus pendant, any of the Tauruses that we create, and any of the coils all create that same toroidal field. Well, let's see, another question. What's the difference between the new Alchemist Taurus pendant and the Divine I Am Activator pendant? Is the latter pendant also updated to the new energetics? So the Divine I Am Activator pendant is not updated into this new energetics. The Divine I Am Activator pendant is more of a, I was looking at this the other day too, and it is more of one of those that you just, it gets in and gets things done, and it just, it moves and it does the work. You know, I mean, this is something that just goes in and cuts, and it just, it does the work. Where the Alchemist Taurus pendant is more of, okay, here is this field that you're going to harmonize to. So basically, the Alchemist Taurus, it creates this field. You become part of that field. It's a very peaceful thing, but it's so flipping powerful. It will start to transform everything in your creation. The Divine Alchemist pendant, it's more, or the Divine I Am pendant, sorry. The Divine I Am pendant is more just come in and just trips the stuff away, and it just activates you, and it's kind of fast and hard. It gets in and does the work. I mean, I've seen people go through those transformations just instantly. Pretty wild. Where the Taurus pendant, it's going to be a lot more refined, gentle, peaceful. It just depends on your path and how you like to go. They're both going to take you to the same place, truly. They're both working for the same purpose, and that is to help you release and help you become you fully. They're just doing it in a different way. So, you know, I would say feel into them, because if you just sit with a picture of each of those and just go into the heart space, imagine having it on, you'll feel it. You'll be able to feel how that one interacts with you. And then you can choose from there. So have your intention when you set with that picture of that tool, have the intention, say, hey, I want to feel this. I want to feel what this would feel like with me. And go into the heart, imagine that tool, imagine you're wearing it right there on your chest, and go with what you feel. Bernard, I wear the heavy gauge new energy ring and clip the new energy coil to the Divine I Am Activator pendant. Whew, wow. Yeah, that feels pretty phenomenal. Very cool. And that's it. Is that Divine I Am Activator pendant? I still think that we can smooth it out a little bit. It's a powerful flipping pendant. It really is. Hey, speaking of that heavy gauge new energy ring, somebody was asking us about making some larger size new energy rings, like those little ones we got. This is one of the 333s. It's a little tough to get over my hand. We also have the 222, the smaller version, which we're still doing time studies on. The 222s are still in the shop. And we'll probably have to do one size larger, because this just barely fits over my hand. But that is that heavier gauge, that new energy ring, kind of like that small 1 1/4 inch or 1.5 inch new energy ring, same gauge. But yeah, Bernard, that does feel really good. Okay, Jen, what is a good one for clearing family lineage? The wisdom wands are phenomenal for clearing family lineage. You know, because the wisdom wands, you only need a soft intention. So if you're holding your wisdom wand or your wisdom wand pendant and you are, excuse me, and you're having that intention of wanting to clear the family lineage, and then you go into the heart space, you sit with the tool and you allow the work to happen, and it happens. With some of the other tools, the space that they would hold, you know, you'd have to go in with a little bit of a, you know, of a harder intention. You'd have to, you know, step in and just be like, okay, this is what we're doing and let's get this work done. I'm going to witness it and all that stuff. Where the wisdom tools, the wisdom fields, you know, especially with that wisdom wand, all it takes is that soft intention. You don't have to be the witness. You don't have to, you know, all that stuff. So for family lineage, I'd sure suggest the wisdom tools and especially the wisdom wand. Does the quantum heart coil have the new energy? Yes, the quantum heart coil does, because that is also in that wisdom energetics. So yes, the quantum heart coils do contain that new energetics as well. And does the quantum heart coil work for Slim's Rainmaker? Man, I get a yes and a no on that. Yes, it could. I think if you just sit down with that. So basically, it's kind of like you can create Slim's Rainmaker without having to own any of the tools. I mean, you can use a physical representation. You can use a pencil as the coils, and as long as your attention is on there, it's going to be doing that work. You can assemble this energetically without having to have any physical tools, and you can imagine the Slim's Rainmaker right there, and as long as your attention is onto it, it's going to be doing the work. But as soon as your attention is not on it, then it's gone. So that's kind of what it was showing me on the yes and the no with the quantum heart coil, is that yes, you can make it work that way, but it's going to take more of your attention onto it for it to hold that, is what I'm feeling. I don't know. I feel that yes, you can totally make that work. That would hold the space that you set your rings, you set your four quantum heart coil pendants, and just let it be. I feel that it should work for you. And I feel that the reason that would work is simply that you step in and that's your intention when you set it there. And then because the coils are the space holders anyway, they will hold the attention for you. So yes, it will work with your intention and your attention onto there. And then after your intention is there, those coils, those quantum heart coils are holding the field. They will continue to hold the field no matter if your attention is on there or not. Sorry for the long walkabout on that. I was really trying to figure out what it was and how it was that I was seeing it. But yes, the quantum heart coils will work. You just sit there the first time and you intend that they're doing the job. After that, they're going to do the job. So yes, they most certainly will. Let's see. Can the fields be anchored into custom pendants, or is it better on your tensor tools? So it's the tensor fields that hold the etheric templates, the energetic anchoring. So the etheric templates that we work with can only be anchored in to the space holder, the physical space holder. So the tensor rings are the physical space holder. Crystals can be physical space holders as well, but not as potent and powerful of a field as a tensor field is. So with the crystals, I mean, so with putting the attention into field. So then here's the other thing, because I'm not sure on, can the fields be anchored into custom pendants? So the tensor field is what we connect to the etheric templates to bring in all of the magic and miracles into which are the etheric templates into the physical, into the physical tools. Now, if you want to anchor energetics in, the tensor field generators, because of their geometries, will hold and amplify intentions. That so because of the geometry, you can put what you want into this field and it will hold your intentions. So as far as custom pendants, it has to be a tensor ring that we've created that we anchor in the template to, in order for it to hold the fields. I'm not sure if I answered your question correctly there, Vindy, so please do ask for some verification on that if you need there. Lizzie, would the new 3.25 energy tensor ring be stronger or more effective than the Wi-Fi tensor ring for Wi-Fi and et cetera? Sorry, I'm just trying to determine which of that 3.25 new energy. Oh, that 3.25. Okay, sorry, I was trying to remember what ring it was that you were speaking about. So any of the new energy, okay, let me put it this way. The Wi-Fi ring, the Wi-Fi and the Wi-Fi tab and all of that were originally, well, they were last at the Golden Fire. The Golden Fire at the time was the most powerful for working with electromagnetics, because it was the most harmonizing field. So after the Golden Fire, there we have a lot of tools that came after the Golden Fire, and all of those are, everything is in the newest. So in that newest energetics, it is built upon everything that we've built upon to there. So most definitely, anything beyond the Golden Fire is just going to be even better for electromagnetics, not just because they're going to all harmonize the electromagnetic field, the same. You can't harmonize a field any more. I mean, it can't get more harmonized. It'll harmonize the field of the electromagnetic field, but it's going to be bringing through a lot more levels, layers, and potentials, because like the new energy, it contains all these potentials and possibilities, like for all the releasing work, which releasing equals healing, releasing, balancing equals healing. So, if you take, so the Golden Fire disc, the cell tab, the Golden Fire disc, well, we call it now the smart meter disc. These are both no longer Golden Fire. These have been updated along the way. At first, it was the Divine I Am. Now it's the new energy. So truly, we don't put any one specific. So that's what I don't list these under new energy, because they are what's brought into the etheric templates for these two here that are working specifically for the electromagnetics. Is all of the highest potentials and possibilities that are in the highest and best for every person to receive them. So these could have the new energy in them. These could have only the Golden Fire. It is between you and your soul what comes through. But I tell you, the energetics on all of your electrical clearing, and that includes the Wi-Fi ring as well, they are in the highest potential that they can be for in the highest and best good. So short answer to, is the newer energies better than the Wi-Fi ring even? Yeah, no. The older Wi-Fi rings, yes. So if you bought a Wi-Fi ring years ago, it's not going to have the same energetics as the Wi-Fi rings that we've made today. So every time I make a new batch of Wi-Fi rings, or every time we make a new batch, I twist a new batch of cell phone tabs, it is always brought into the highest potentials of the energies at that moment. So a Wi-Fi ring that you bought 3 or 4 years ago is not going to be the same as the Wi-Fi ring that you have now. Basically, they're still going to be doing the same work with EMFs, but the newer ones are just going to be bringing through more. So I hope that answers that question too. Tommy, I would like to know more about the new Taurus. I have a Taurus pendant. Is this shifted now also? And know that the Taurus pendant, the silver Taurus pendant that we had before, that was that harmonic creation field trio. So it had that regeneration ring, and it had the golden fire. And what was the other one? I believe the other one was the harmony, I believe. So that particular Taurus was that tensor trio, the harmonic creation field trio, which was that trio that was right before the alchemist set. So it was still a fantastic pendant. And of course, those energies have shifted more throughout time. But as far as the new Taurus pendant that we have out, it is completely, you know, you could consider it as an alchemist set. That one side had, that there is the, you know, that within that Taurus, there's the three energies of the alchemist set. There's the harmonizer, the chalice, and the divine I am. And then those energies are working together that bring through the wisdom and that new energy. So the newest Taurus, it's another step up from the silver Taurus that we had before. Not to say that the silver Taurus that you have now is not viable. It is still a fantastic pendant. The only reason we're not making it anymore is just for simplicity for us and for consumer, by just having the one single Taurus pendant. And it's actually even easier for us to make than the older one, which is why they're still the same price, even with that added veil and all that extra work, is because it's still easier to make too. So the older Taurus pendant, what I would suggest, and I need to do a little video on this because I've talked about it in 50 Questions Friday, is taking your wisdom ring or your wisdom wand, and that you can shift the energetics of any of your energy tools into a higher vibrational space, into a higher potentiality. So if you take your Taurus and you take your wisdom wand or your wisdom ring and you sit with them together, you go into the heart space and you just simply ask that your Taurus be brought to the newest energy possible in the highest and best for you. And you don't have to worry about wording it correctly. When you're in your heart space, your soul knows your intention beyond the words. You just allow. Just allow, and you'll feel the shift. So you can still shift your old Taurus into the highest potential energies for you. That is something that we need to do a video on sometime. So yeah, Tommy, please do sit and check that out and see about shifting that. And then we'll totally do a video here sometime. Nika, I've been wearing this silver trio of rings with a new energy sampler ring added on a chain. I love the energy of this combo. Is there a tool that creates a toroidal field in this energetic? I know, you know, I still love the alchemist set, and then that's wonderful that you could tell a big difference when you added that new energy ring to it. And thank you for that feedback on that energetic, and certainly play with that, because there's so many different combinations that we can come up with these energies that they just feel amazing. It's like you create something new by just playing with combinations of tools and energies. Let's see, Renard. So as you were talking about the Rainmaker, I saw it spinning energetically counterclockwise. Has anything been mentioned with that tool and directions? No, you know, we were always shown just setting it on the ground as far as working with it in that fashion. But man, you know, as you know, that energetic, it's so multi-purposed that you could do a lot more with it. So I like that idea, Renard, of having that spinning, you know, and you could have it spinning, because, you know, you can put your Rainmakers into epoxy and it's fine and it doesn't hurt a thing. And that's really a great way to do it, because then, you know, you can hang it this way and spin it, or you can hang it horizontally and spin it. I'm not sure which way you were seeing spinning. And at first I thought you were talking about this, but now I'm kind of thinking you were talking about this. But any way that you do it, it's fantastic. It's probably going to create a whole new something. You know, it might be used for the same thing, for the same purpose, or it might be just a whole different purpose and reason for the field too. It has a beautiful thing about the tools and the Rainmaker as well, because the Rainmaker also does all of that work with GMOs. Holy smokes. To me, that is the hugest thing with Slim's Rainmaker, and it probably needs a different name. It was just kind of an on-the-fly name that I gave it at the time. But, you know, it's powerful in the removing of GMOs and the effects of GMOs on the bodies and the environment, herbicides in the environment, all of that. The Rainmaker is perfect for bees. Oh, my goodness. Put one of those on top of your beehive, and, man, I could almost guarantee that you produce at least twice the amount of honey. You know, we've seen people doing it with similar tools. The gal who wrote Bees Healing Beans. Let me see if I have her book sitting right here. Valerie Solheim. My library's right here. Valerie Solheim wrote the Beehive Effect, Bees Healing Beans. And she used, because Slim was around when she was there, so she used some of Slim's tools and everything with the hives, and she produced like three times the amount of honey as everybody around her, and her bees didn't die. So yeah, it's the point of that story is, yeah, please do keep playing. And Renard, thank you for playing with the tools, and thank you for sharing what you find with them. We need you to come here and play at the studio for a few days, Renard. I really do. Vindy. Okay, so to clarify, so we're just going to clarify the question that Vindy asked earlier about anchoring energetics. So to clarify, I intended to ask if you can anchor the energetics of the field you're bringing in into the tools to a pendant, which is not a tensor ring. Is in anchoring the divine I am energetics to a pendant of mine, which is not a tensor ring. So, gosh, that's a tough one. Because with something like that, it's like in our workshops that we do, and we do muscle testing to see if your cell phone's beneficial to you. And then we take a paper clip, and we take that paper clip, let's say that's your piece of jewelry, and you can sit there and you can run energy into it. You know, you can say, okay, I'm changing the energetics of this paperclip to where it will transmute all electromagnetic fields and make my cell phone beneficial. You take the paperclip and you put it on your phone and you muscle test and you find that it did just that. That paperclip, you drop it on the ground, somebody else picks it up. They think it's only a paperclip and that is all it's going to be doing for them, because that paperclip was simply a space holder for your attention and your intentions. And as long as your attention was on that paperclip, your intentions were there. That paperclip was a cell phone transformer. Same with your piece of jewelry. Is that there is nothing to hold that field in there permanently. Now, crystals can hold some of that on the surface. I believe these wisdom fields, they can hold it more internalized than on the surface. But still, with your piece of jewelry, that energetic will be there for you. So you can do that with your jewelry. And as long as your attention is onto it, it will be bringing through that energetic. But as soon as you are no longer, it's no longer in your awareness, it's just a piece of jewelry again. But you can certainly do it, because then every time you see it, touch it, feel it, anytime it comes into your awareness, it's carrying that field. So that's perfect to do. And again, just go into the heart space and ask. Ask for those templates to be brought in. And it will hold for as long as your attention is on there, which could be quite often throughout the day. What would you say the energetic difference between the quantum heart pendant and the tensor coil pendant are? So the quantum heart pendant, yes, kind of like what I mentioned last week too, was that quantum heart pendant, that quantum heart coil pendant, it's more of an encapsulating field. It's more of this, it's more of just a safe space for somebody who just is not able to function because they're so discombobulated. So that quantum heart coil pendant, it does create that safe container. Now the tensor coils, they are more open. They have more flow. They're just more open and more flowing. That's how I see the energy of the two. Nika, it's the Silver Alchemist rings I have. And I love that Silver Alchemist set. And yes, so if you add the Alchemist rings and you add that new energy to it, like I say, anytime you're working with the tools and you can add different energies in the way the fields move, add different movement to the fields, you'll be surprised in finding all kinds of cool things, things that just make you feel good or that show you that has a specific purpose for you. So let's see. Jumping back over here to chat real quick. So just getting the feedback here too. And yeah, that's kind of what it seems like everybody's kind of thinking is, maybe like once every 2 weeks for the 50 Questions Friday here. And we'll see. Again, I'll just kind of feel into that because I would like to start doing more video blogs and presentations and energy updates, just things like that, because, we really want to create more content for social media to get us out there more, because we really need to expand our customer base, not only for us to keep continuing on without having to shrink, because I don't want to shrink Twisted Sage. I want it to keep expanding and growing. And I want it to be beneficial for our employees. I want it to be beneficial for all of you, for the world. So anyway, what was that tangent about? Well, I guess just always happy that you guys share everything with everybody, and thank you for telling people about us and sharing the tools. And I know a lot of you share the tools a lot, and thank you so much, because it truly is the word of mouth that helps people connect with the tools. Because, in this world where everybody's trying to sell you everything and it's all a bunch of crap, it's hard to find what's actually good. Let's see. Check in here. Okay, got a couple more questions. Hi, Brian. Will you be making the tensor coils in a smaller pendant version? Oh, so, Johan, we do have the tensor coils with the infinity on them. And those are that smaller version. And those ones are the same size as that of this coil, but it includes the infinity and the coil. It's a smaller diameter and it's a lot lighter gauge. So it's a lot better. Well, it's a better pendant to wear for not being so large and bulky. But it's definitely not as small as the Quantum Heart coil pendants. But yeah, so we do make that the tensor coil just in that tensor coil pendant with infinity. We used to make larger ones, but I don't think we're going to make larger ones at the moment. Too hard on the hands. If I want to release a specific thought, emotion, feeling by holding it, what would be the best tool to assist in releasing those? For releasing anything, the wisdom wand is the way to go. Because the wisdom wand, when you go into that field of the wisdom wand, you have the backing of your divine awareness, of your light. And when you put your divine awareness onto anything, a situation, a reoccurring thing, a reaction, whatever it is that you put divine awareness onto, it will either shift that entire creation or else it will shift your reaction to that creation. I have not met a thing that I could not shift either the creation or my reaction to that creation by simply using the wisdom wand. I cannot say enough about the wisdom wand and the potentials to shift all creation. That field, it is such an empowering field. So most definitely, Vindy, the wisdom wands are one that you can use to release those reoccurring thoughts as they come up. As you go into the heart space, because the reason that wisdom wand works so well is that it doesn't try to mask or band-aid that little thing that comes in. It goes to the core of it, no matter where the core of that is, no matter what lifetime, what planet, what solar system, whatever, wherever it is that little core of thing came in, that brought up those thoughts, those reoccurring thoughts, that stems from somewhere within your creation or else somewhere outside of you. And so when you let that go, your divine awareness is going to go through and clear whatever the source of that creation is and everything in between. It really is huge. So let's see, going back. Carla, have you ever been on Gaia with George Nouri beyond belief? No, you know, I'm totally, I think in this next year or two or three is going to be huge for me getting out there with a lot of this new information and ideas and observations and the tools and the fields and what we're doing. I really feel like we're going to step out there a lot more in the next few years. In more alignment, because this year I turned down all of these cool big things that I'm supposed to be doing this year, this summer, because they're all about the old paradigm, because I was pretty, you know, I was pretty versed in the old paradigm of being the spiritual light warrior and the clearing work and, you know, all the stuff, which is old paradigm. And so I really feel as we step into this new paradigm, we're going to be bringing through a lot more cool stuff. Let's see. I think we might be all the way through here for the day. Gosh, I will try to get I'll try to get that thing from the medicine wheel put up. I just need to redo the audio for it and put it out there because it's... Gosh, it's just a powerful experience that we actually filmed and would just love to share it with you guys because it's an amazing field. So anyway, thank you all for being here. I was trying to think if there was anything else here coming up. We're just starting to book shows again. Here the past week, I've been booking all of our old holistic fairs within, you know, a day's drive of South Dakota. And so if you have any events that you feel we might be interested in, if you're not more than 10 hours from the Black Hills here, we would love to consider that. And because we're ready to get out there and to bring some more of these tools and experiences to people. And so the events that I go to, I like to set up our big pyramid, which is our 13-foot tall copper pyramid that we use as a vending booth, and as well as just a, as like a reset station, do sessions in there as well as vend tools. But I would also love to start presenting some of these new concepts. In November, the first part of November, we'll be in Wisconsin. We're just booking a two different weekend workshops there. And so we're going to start bringing in some new workshops on the newer consciousness work, because we've done the Transcending the Matrix Beyond Duality, which was all about, you know, that fulcrum point of coming from the light warrior-ness stuff that we've all been doing as light workers, to us having the realization of, hey, light work is truly us being in our power. And from here on out, the next Transcending the Matrix workshops are going to be about amassing consciousness. That's going to be huge, because that's the work that we do with the wisdom tools. And then the second part of that series is going to be, well, conscious creation. What do you do with all that consciousness, and how do you allow it to work for you? So anyway, it's going to be huge. Yay. Yeah. Thank you all for being here, you guys. Appreciate it. And, we'll see you guys next round, whenever that is, either this next week or the week after. And I was trying to think if there was anything else. You know, weather's been coming up a lot recently, and our participation in the shifting of weather patterns in our local area as well as on the planet. That was my intention for the medicine wheel, but it was not quite that. It was more the clearing work. But I still feel like the Slim's Rainmaker and working with the earth elementals, that's going to be one of the things that I'm really going to be pushing for this fall too, is working more with the earth, with weather patterns and conscious creation of weather. Because I think we all need to step in and start taking that responsibility. So anyway, all right. Love you guys too. All right. We'll see you next time. Have a great week, you guys.